Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose teaching is life, whose presence is sure, and whose love is endless.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sins to the one who welcomes us with an open heart. God, our comforter, like lost sheep, we have gone astray. We gaze upon abundance and see scarcity. We turn our faces away from injustice and oppression. We exploit the earth with our apathy and greed. Free us from our sin, gracious God. Listen when we call out to you for help. Lead us by your love to love our neighbors as ourselves. Amen.
All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. By the gift of grace in Christ Jesus, God makes you righteous. Receive with glad hearts the forgiveness of all your sins.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Generous God, your Son gave his life that we might come to peace with you. Give us a share of your Spirit, and in all we do, empower us to bear the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from James. Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up, and anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Elijah was a human being like us, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain. And for 3 years and 6 months, it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth yielded its harvest. My brothers and sisters, if anyone among you wanders from the truth and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you?
exceedingly. Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Thank you. And that is, dear friends, the filter which we need to pour all of Scripture through. Grace and mercy and the love of Jesus. If your eye causes you to stumble, pluck it out. Now, of course, this is about lust. But I want you to think about this. How many good school administrators have sent girls home because they wore clothing that somebody found? The word was offensive, but we could just say it was pretty. Because they feel uncomfortable. What this passage says is, if you're feeling something that you know is not right, if you're feeling something that's causing a rift between you and God and you and neighbor, look at yourself. That's exactly what he was saying to the Pharisees when they were talking about hand washing. Look at yourself before you point. Surprised. And the
grace and mercy and love of Jesus will come back to you 100-fold. May the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Please join me now in our prayers of intercession. Made children and heirs of God's promise, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. We pray for the church and its ministry. Bless the newly baptized and encourage them in their journey of faith. Sustain all members of the body of Christ in lives of prayer, service, and worship. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for natural wonders of your creation. Restore damaged forests, waterways, and natural habitats, and lead us to be good stewards of what you have provided. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those in authority. Give them wise minds and compassionate hearts. Strengthen them in desire to protect the vulnerable and care for those underserved. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are struggling with cancer, dementia, or any other disease. Provide them with peace and resilience for the days ahead. Sustain caregivers with energy and patience. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the worship leaders of this congregation, musicians, readers, acolytes, and ushers. Bless us through their ministry and grant them the passion to continue in their service. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give thanks for all your saints, those we have loved and known, and those from every time and place. Continue to guide us by their example and reassure us of your promised salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
night our Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, he blessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, given and shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
as you come to the table today, come up the center aisle. You'll receive the bread, you'll receive the wine, and there's receptacles for the wine cups by each of the folds. Now come to the table, for God's meal is ready.
This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you.
Blood of Christ shed for you.
Body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the body of Christ given for you.
Blood of Christ.
This is the body of Christ given for you.
Blood of Christ.
Blood of Christ.